And a potential game changer in the fight against fentanyl. This is exciting. A biotech company says it is developing a vaccine that would block the fatal synthetic opioid before it reaches the brain. Rich Edson, live in Washington with details. Hi, Rich.
Good morning, Dana. ARMR Sciences says its fentanyl vaccine is showing signs of early success, and in just weeks, the company will begin clinical trials in Europe. Even a small amount of fentanyl, equal to a few grains of salt, is deadly. It's also cheap, highly addictive, and mixed in street drugs and bogus pharmaceuticals. ARMR says its vaccine will block fentanyl from reaching the brain. That would prevent fentanyl's effects, the feeling of euphoria, overdose, and potentially death, and also hopefully protect those who accidentally come in contact with it.
I want to make this as easily accessible to people as I possibly can, both to law enforcement, military, first responders, but also people, you know, suffering from opioid use disorder, and also to people who are fentanyl naive, the inadvertent poisonings that happen every single day in the United States.
ARMR says it's also developed a methamphetamine vaccine and is working on a cocaine vaccine. The company also says its fentanyl vaccine will serve as a platform for emerging drug threats, which law enforcement says cartels are already pushing into the United States.
Being way more dangerous and deadly synthetic opioids like carfentanil, like nitazine, etanitazine, metanitazine, protonitazine. These are substances that in some cases could be, you know, 20, 40, 50, 100 times more potent than fentanyl.
The first phases of the vaccine's clinical trial begin in the Netherlands with about 40 adults. The company says it intends to then begin trials in the United States and potentially request fast-track approval. Dana?
Fascinating. Thank you.
Dr. Marc Siegel joins us now. Doc, good morning to you and congratulations. Author of the New York Times number one bestseller, The Miracles Among Us, How God's Grace Plays a Role in Healing. Well done. Available right now for our viewers at home. Doc, here we go now. This stuff is highly addictive. 100 times more than morphine, 50 times more than heroin. The number of deaths, according to the CDC last year, 42,000. That number is trending lower, which we like, but what about this idea? Do you medically like it?
I love it. And by the way, the deaths are trending lower because of Narcan, the antidote, but the problem is that we can't get that to everybody, and it only lasts for a day or two at most. Even if you use repeated doses, fentanyl can last 2 to 3 days. So even if you give the Narcan, it doesn't work. What's remarkable about this, and I'll call it a medical miracle, is that we're learning how to get the immune system of the body to recognize fentanyl as a foreign invader. The reason it can't do it usually is it's too small. Fentanyl is really small. It's just one molecule. But they figured out a way in Houston, and ARMR is using the technology from Houston and combining it, and now, as Rich just said, testing it in the Netherlands. They found a way to combine it with another protein, and when you prime the immune pump, again, our immune system is out there looking for things to protect us against. Fentanyl slips in under the radar, but when you give it with a co-molecule, you tell the immune system, hey, fentanyl may be coming. And then when it sees fentanyl, it makes antibodies and attacks the fentanyl before it ever gets to the brain. And all those side effects you see are from fentanyl in the brain. So
wow,
this is very
okay,
exciting.
Yeah, amazing. Let me give you a quick pop quiz on that. Is there anything that exists today as this relates to any other type of medicine that affects the human body?
There's not because, well, everything I just described is the way all vaccines work, by the way, but we can't get the immune system to see this as a foreign invader. They're also making antibodies. Remember those monoclonal antibodies that work so well with COVID? They're also making those antibodies that you could actually take if you're addicted to fentanyl, and you inject those antibodies, and those will knock it out, too. So we're really moving forward on medical science against fentanyl just when we need it. 74,000 overdose deaths last year from fentanyl, as Rich said.
100%. Another story for you. A new pill. You know, Ozempic's like the rage, right? You get the shot, you lose weight. It happens over 3 or 4 months' time. You see somebody you haven't bumped into in 6 months, and they've changed. I mean, they just look different, all right? Well, this pill will burn the fat without the muscle loss. And just as a scene setter for you, obesity in America, 2 in 5 adults apparently, 58% have high blood pressure in America. That's a risk factor for heart disease. 23% have diabetes, and we got $173 billion in medical expenditures 6 years ago. Does this work? Do you like the idea, doctor?
I don't love it, and I told you and Dana, who look like you belong on a magazine cover, never going to need medicines like this. But the truth is that I don't care that much about the muscle loss. Some people do, but I think the GLP-1s are already a grand slam homer because they work a lot of ways. They decrease hunger in the brain. They slow gastric emptying. They overcome insulin resistance. They decrease inflammation in the body. They're good for your heart. They're good for your brain. It looks like they keep you alive longer. The GLP-1s are now going to become available in pills. They're not for everyone, but they are for the obese. And I like the idea of a drug that causes the immune system to rev up, like the one you're talking about. But we've tried that before. That's not going to work as well as these GLP-1s do. Wow. So I don't see this as a competition at all.
This is amazing.
I like what we already have.
Yeah. You know, with all this technology, are we changing the way people live?
There's no question about it, Bill, but there's still nothing better than the gym, and there's nothing better than eating fruit and vegetables and sleeping at night. How about we go back to that, and then we have these things as tools when we need them?
Good answer. Thank you, Doc. Dane and I are going to get our picture.
Great to see you guys.
Hey, everyone. I'm Emily Campagno. Catch me and my co-hosts Harris Faulkner and Kaylee McEnany on Outnumbered every weekday at 12 p.m. Eastern, or set your DVR. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the Fox News YouTube page for daily highlights.